Imagine if all species on Earth suddenly became equally mentally developed. If every animal and every insect on our planet suddenly had a mind, would we live peacefully and happily together? No. Most definitely, a third world war would begin, the most epic war one could possibly imagine. And in this war of wars, who would win? Man or monkey? Or maybe even elephant? Who has the best chance? Now, there is no chance that anything like this could ever happen. Such an insane idea is nothing but the fruit of my imagination and nothing more. This could only happen in a bizarre parallel universe, and even that possibility is vanishingly unlikely. But still, any conflict implies a certain number of warring parties. In our case, we are people, humans, mankind, and all the others are those who could possibly harm us. Of course, we can imagine that we could ally ourselves with the other primates. Well, our faithful dog friends will certainly cover our backs. But no, that's for some other time. Let's imagine that everyone is against us. And truthfully, it's not even clear whether all humans will fight together as one, or, as is too often the case in our history, divide into several warring camps and fight amongst ourselves. Man's most dangerous enemy is still man himself. You may ask yourself, why would animals fight? Well, why not? We do it. Besides, considering how many species we have already exterminated, there is little doubt that in this scenario there could be some alternative outcome. All living beings on our planet have just received a mind equal to ours. They are intelligent. Why should they suddenly have to act differently than we have? And the truth is, as will soon become clear to all the various intelligent species, that several different species cannot reign on one planet at the same time. So, first and foremost, all of the inhabitants of the rivers, seas, and oceans are losers. They won't be able to leave the boundaries of their watery confines. In principle, this applies to all animals which are limited by the need to stay in their accustomed habitat, be it water, rainforests, swamps, or deserts. They can fight for dominance in their domain, but they cannot claim the whole planet if they do not find allies. Which scenario is most likely to play out? Also, most probably, the majority of herbivores will keep their distance, since they need to spend the bulk of their time eating grass in order to replenish their strength before rushing into battle. Large animals like tigers, lions, wolves, and bears, as well as elephants and rhinoceroses, these are a real threat. These guys could easily win the day, if we humans were still naked apes running through the woods and across the prairie. But this is not to be. Evolution has its advantages. It has given us weapons of every shape and size, and we are able to use them. You want your grizzly bear enemies shot full of lead? You got it. You want an elephant fried on a nuclear grill? Easy as pie. You understand what I'm getting at. Even with brains, all the large and very dangerous animals are all big zeros in comparison with man and his huge arsenal. All except for the other great apes. Let's take, for example, the gorilla or the chimpanzee. In terms of their functionality, they're like a demo version of a person. At least they were until they got an elite human equivalent mind. All the same functionality. The ability to pick up tools, use machines, or something even greater. And most importantly, they have strength. The body. The sheer muscular power of most great apes and large monkeys is far superior to that of us humble humans. Add to that a brain the equal of ours, and this is no longer just a demo version, but rather something superior to Homo sapiens. They could quickly and easily learn our technology and bring us a lot of trouble. Therefore, apes deservedly place second in the ranking of the most dangerous living creatures with brains. But who or what is first? Can you guess? Microbes. They are everywhere, even inside of us. Yes, it's completely absurd to give human-level minds to creatures that do not even have a nervous system, but everything is possible in our imagination. So microbes and bacteria also achieve the status of acceptable. Now we really have something to fear. If the apes are more or less equal-level rivals, and as is likely that we could deal with them, then overcoming the microbes, well, this is impossible. Microbes are the most tenacious earthlings there are, and a necessary component of our own existence. Life on the planet Earth is impossible without microbes. Everything on our world, from bugs to elephants, exists only thanks to microbes. And man is no exception, especially modern man. Small and inconspicuous, they help our bodies digest food and synthesize vital nutrients. In short, microbes are the most important necessity for the existence of the entire organic world on our planet Earth. Life in any of its manifestations is not possible without them. In conclusion, if suddenly microbes learn to think like man, any war for the domination of our planet will be completely meaningless. To be sure, reasoning microbes? That would be quite exotic. Mosquitoes, on the other hand, more than 500,000 people die every year even from stupid mosquitoes. Imagine what they could do if they had a brain. If suddenly all the species on Earth became equally intelligent and began to fight with each other, victory is likely to be won not by the largest and most powerful, but by the smallest and most tenacious inhabitants of our planet. But don't worry, it's not going to happen. Remember, it's all just a fantasy. Write in the comments the topics you want to hear about, and maybe next time we'll make a video of your idea. Thanks for your attention, and see you next time.